There are four examples dating back from 2005, 2004, around that area. And the first one comes from South Sudan, which just before independence was announced, a large agreement or contract was signed to make the largest natural park in South Sudan, which was signed by UAE company. And funnily enough, that the size of the park would be about just a bit bigger than the size of the UAE itself. The plan actually collapsed altogether due to the fact that when the study was made for the park, the understanding is the people who live in that area they would be provided with housing, with hospitals, with schools by the buyer of the land. However, the thing that they failed to understand is that these people were more of nomads. They moved around, they liked to graze and farm their cattle all around the areas, in and out of that land. So ultimately, the program to develop that natural park completely fell apart. The government of North Sudan and the UAE, UAE suggested to buy a large portion of land, but to set up a full logistics hub there, including an airport, warehousing, transportation, and they will completely fund it. They will completely build it up. They will bring in Sudanese workers. They will even produce enough food to supply the Sudanese market as well as the UAE market. However, at that point in time, it was when Sudan and the UAE were not in a good place politically together. And it ended up, the plan was basically pulled out because of a disagreement between the two governments on how to go forward. Ultimately, this resulted in the setup of a company called Al-Dhahra Agriculture, which started investments in various African countries, but mainly in Serbia, where they were importing a lot of goods. And that developed a rapprochement between Serbia and the UAE, where there is now security ties, diplomatic ties, and very strong commercial ties. Following that, in as recent as 2014, where Qatari aid to Sudan was held back because most of the aid products were being sent through and not reaching their intended locations, whether it be through corruption or through straight-out thievery. The Qatari government dealt with this issue by sending out their own agents and their own people to follow and track through the progress of aid distribution from aircraft to person in need. And that's and in that sense, Qataris kind of understood what's at stake here, and the impact of their aid had a lot more value than other agencies. United Arab Emirates and the Somaliland deal for the military base and the DP World ports. Now this is a good example of how a deal can go right. The UAE and Somaliland signed these agreements in 2016 to build a military base, to build and develop a port for Somaliland. And this issue is quite important because alongside it, there has been clauses of infrastructure development that involve humanitarian aid, human capital development, security for the region. So it's more of a complete, well-rounded approach to an aid program in return for some strategic assets. Mm-hmm.